Hey everyone, this is Bruce Muffson, LCSW from Sunridge of Nevada. Once again, we're going to be discussing various topics, and the topic today is going to be Mac Miller's last album, Swimming. As everyone knows, this album was released in August 3rd of 2018, and unfortunately, less than a month later, on September 7th, he passed away through a drug overdose. What we're going to do is we're going to break down each one of his songs, starting with the second one. We've already done his first song, Come Back to Earth. And what we're going to do is a little bit different this time, is that we're changing up our focus a little bit, in that for those of you that are watching with us and kind of grown up with us, we've always gone and we've done like 35, 40 minutes per video, and I've broken down each and every lyric. This time's going to be a little bit different. I'm only going to be breaking down select lines that I think are relevant to the overall depth of what he was dealing with, and then I'm going to come down with really emphasize the clinical aspects of what issues he was, you know, striving with and confronting with, such as his depression, anxiety, stress, social isolation, not caring about things, sleeping too much. So that's all to give you an idea of not just understanding Mac Miller better and understanding what he was going through, but to also begin to understand yourselves better. So when these things happen with yourself or with loved ones and friends around you, you now have the signs and awareness of what to look out for, what to say, what to ask, and how to go forward in helping to prevent what happened to Mac happening to everyone here that's going to be watching these videos. Okay. Swimming was a great album, there's no argument, and it was a fantastic album, and it got a very, very strong reviews, and of all of his albums, of his five albums, this one that was the furthest on the charts. Interestingly enough, of all the reviews that took place, and they were generally very positive and very favorable, very few of the reviewers really, really touched upon his mental health issues that he was dealing with. The one that I felt was the most relevant of all of them was a comment by Trey Alston of High Snobbity. He concluded that Swimming is the authentic self-destruction album so many artists have attempted before. Here, Mac is in rare form, chronicling his destruction and rebirth in a way that shows his acknowledgement of the path ahead, but reluctance to step on it without the certainty of companionship at the end, which comes up a lot, companionship, friendship. Whether he continues to walk that path is ultimately up to him, but the Mac that's featured on Swimming will find his way from the darkness. In the process, he's given us a beautiful means to mark the turn of his narrative. Okay, which was interesting and good, some good insight. Now I want to go into the first of the songs that we have here. And also I want to share something else as well. We obviously talk a lot about mental health issues, duh. But at this time also, we're going to go for the total picture. And I talked about this with my team, and what we had come up with was some other areas that we need to clarify and define for those that are watching, which are, besides the mental health, it's physical, social, environmental, emotional, and spiritual. In other words, to give you a full picture of what you're looking at and realize not everything is mental health. A lot of times it is, but it's also issues of your environment, who you hang out with, how's your physical health, what's your spiritual health? All these different aspects really give you the total personality of the person and give you a better understanding, not just of Mac Miller and what he was going through, but what you and I and everyone else in this world go through as well. So here we go. This is going to be the second song of the album. It's called Hurt Feelings. And what I want really people to start doing is to learn how to read the signs. Obviously, I have the advancement of doing thousands and thousands of clinical sessions where I look at people, observe them, see how they dress, what they say, what they don't say, and I learn to listen to what they do say and what they don't say as well. So here, in a lot of every one of the songs I'm going to be doing today, there are things that he says that to me just jump out, leap out. And as I said before, had I been his clinical social worker and I saw this album, you know, in itself when it first came out, I would have said this person needs to be admitted for observation reasons, because just simply for the way he's writing. So here we go. Second song, Hurt Feelings. And again, I'm not going to be doing every single line. I'm only going to be doing select lines that I think are relevant and going into conclusion of a clinical breakdown of what I see and how it relates to you, the listener. Okay. Don't know what you're missing. Shame on you. Shame on you. From my perspective, he's talking about himself. He's missing out on being happy and also being drug-free. Then it goes on, it goes, I paid the cost to see your party face. That means it's mine. Keep to myself, taking my time. And what he's, to me, he's saying is I had to pretend to keep the real me under lock and key. And what's the price for that? The price for that is death. And always in some BS and out of line. You know, driving with my eyes closed, missing out the signs. So always into some BS is the drugs, the drinking, the depression, being unhappy. And driving with my eyes closed is I can't handle what's in front of me. It's scary. And then there's a line here that one of the commenters, it goes, listening to Whitney and whipping it through the city, yeah. Well, you know, they're talking to Whitney Houston and what she went through. And as a comment by Candy Perkins and one of the commenters, that reference to Whitney Houston said it all. Driving not to slow down. You're going faster and faster and faster. It's never enough. But I'm way too much on my shoulders. Please hold me down. Bring me back to earth. I'm floating. I'm not where I should be. I'm not tethered to reality. I keep my head above the water. And boy, that reference, water, is in almost all the songs. The water, the water, the water. That reference is there over and over. I'll be getting richer, but it only made me crazy. So money, clearly, and fame did not make him happy. Something that we always tend to forget. And I always said I want it all, but it's not enough. Not enough. Then what? How do we really handle success? Because it's lonely at the top. Who do you have with you on the ride? Then it goes further down. It says everything is strange. Everybody tripping. Yeah, nothing is calm. Nothing is settled. And then it goes, turn the power off and get your water from the spring. Again, he's talking about water as a cleanser, as a place to hide into, as a place to sink into. And then used to be feeling depressed. Now that I'm living, I'm feeling obsessed. He didn't say, when he said depressed, he didn't say content or relaxed or at ease. He's feeling obsessed. Nothing is ever for him a relaxed state of mind. And finally, I've been going through it. You just go around it. What he's talking about to me is he's talking about his addiction history. Don't go through it. Don't go what I've been through. Now, what is the point of this song from a clinical perspective? The goal with this song and everything else, I want for you is to listen to certain lyrics and realize what is really being said. And that goes to the conversations that we have with ourselves, with friends, and with family. There's a concept in therapy of speak less and listen more. The older I get, the more sessions that I do, I let the person talk. Because the more they talk, the more I understand where they're coming from. I observe. I look for body language. I look how they're dressed. I look at what they're saying, what they're not saying. I look how they even sit. Are they sitting like this? Are they sitting with the hoodie over their face? I mean, those are obvious signs. They look at their parents. A lot of times the kids, they do this. When they get nervous, they get frightened. They go like that. They flick. With their eyes flick. If a comment I said struck home, their eyes would look at me. I hit home on that one. I got a punch in. So I want people to start realizing these are the things that you're looking for. You don't have to be LCSW, you know, accomplished therapist, you know, legend in his own mind to get this stuff. But when you start becoming patient, you start to notice. And I'm looking for scars on the arm. Are they cutting? You know, what am I looking for? And that's what I do when I'm in therapy. More you say, the better I understand you. And this will help you understand your friends. And if they are in trouble, listen, listen, listen. Just even their haircuts. When I see a kid changing his hairstyle, there's a question in my mind, why? Why? I've had the same haircut since I've been 5. 50 years later, I'm still the same haircut. A lot less hair, but it's still the same haircut. These are like these keys that give it away. Learn to have the confidence to say, is everything all right with you? And do you need my support? Will you need it more? Because the reality is that someone that's giving these kinds of lyrics off, or someone that's talking to you in a certain way, they don't have it under control. And that's what they're trying to say to you in so many words. And in their own way, They're reaching out. Help me. Hold on to me. Don't let me drift off. Don't let me fall. Please, please, please grab on to me. That's what I'm looking for. Okay, and with that, that concludes our first song of the day.